I'm Dr. Suzanne Ruddy. I'm a teaching fellow in the Department of Structural and Molecular Biology, and we're housed in the Darwin Building, which is the site on which Darwin lived for some years after he came back from his trips. I've been at UCL for 3 years, and ever since I arrived, there has been an empty plinth by the Gower Street entrance. And I've sat in discussions in staff meetings where there has been some heated debate about the empty plinth and the removal of Darwin, let's say, by the Grant Museum when they left our building to go across the road on Gower Street. Darwin, unfortunately, has been peeping out of the Grant Museum at us as if to taunt us. I decided that we really should try and do something about this. But it didn't really happen until I became a member of the Institute of Making. And at the induction, I realized that we could use a 3D printer. And I immediately after that went back and emailed one of my bosses in the department and said, we can use this, can we do something for the empty plinth? And she, unknown to me, had discussed this with our head of department, who wanted to put a Darwin bust back on. So the two ideas merged and we ended up with the proposal for a 3D printout of the Darwin bust.
My name's Ellie Doney and I'm the Makespace Manager here at the Institute of Making. We are a cross-faculty research hub for materials and making, a hands-on place where people can come and play with materials, get experimental, and meet people from all over UCL who are also into making, or have the potential to be into making. We've got the workshop, the Makespace, alongside the materials library, which you can see in the background here. And the idea is to think about materials and how they're processed from different perspectives. We got interested in the project when Suzanne came over as a member of the Institute of Making and started getting excited about what we could put in the empty space in the Darwin building. The initial thought was just to recreate Darwin, but then we thought, let's go one better and give our members a bit of a challenge and get them to recreate Darwin in any way that they wanted, because we knew that because they're such an interesting bunch of people from all over UCL, that they'd have much better ideas than we could probably come up with. Together, we went over to the Grant Museum to see the original Darwin, where he lives now, looking out onto Gower Street, and proposed that we scan him. It turns out that Mona Hess, who's a PhD student, had already scanned him, and she'd already scanned him in very, very high quality. So we had all that data. So we thought, from that data, let's challenge the members to make something. Now they can use the data to use computer-controlled machines like milling, 3D printing, slices, using them on the laser cutter, or if they weren't so digitally minded, maybe we could help them use the data to use a print or a machined Darwin to vacuum form or to mould. And then we've teamed up with the CAD-CAM workshop at the Bartlett, which is Emmanuel, Inigo and all their staff, to use some of the data to mill out Darwin in the most spectacular way. They have a new suite of robots, robot arms, and one in particular, Latoya, the giant eight-axis machining system, was perfect for this. It's a new piece of equipment, and they're really keen on experimenting, seeing what they could do with it, and working with other departments. One of our remits here, or one of our aims here at the Institute of Making, is to get people at UCL talking to each other. So encourage interdisciplinary thinking based on materials and making. So this was a perfect project for us, really. It's worked out really well to get not only the departments working together, but the students, the staff, and members working together. As it turned out, some people had similar ideas. We put them in touch with each other. They might be doing collaborative projects. So it couldn't be more perfect.